Mulavinaka Fiji, welcome back to Jejemon. This is our delayed coverage of the annual Miss Water Lily pageant of Andi Cakobau School in Sawani. Before the break, you met the 10 intelligent and confident young women from years 9 and 10 competing for the Princess Water Lily title, also displaying fabulous costumes reflecting her traditional ties. Now let's meet the 11 confident, intelligent young women of years 11, 12 and 13 competing for the title of Miss Water Lily Queen.
Fiji. My name is Zita Anavasinatavea. I hail from the beautiful province of Naitasiri. I'm 16 years of age and I'm proud to represent 1101 in this year's Water Lily pageant.
Bolo Fiji, I'm Finawangai Rundovu, I'm 16 years old, I come from the province of Loma Ebiti, and during this year's Water Lily pageant, I'll be representing year 1103.
Bolo Sia Fiji, my name is Antisien Milingangandam Korvak Turanga, I'm 16 years of age. I'm from the beautiful province of Dakondrave. This year's Water Lily pageant, I'm proud to represent year 1103.
Bulo Fiji, my name is Tokasa Mbulu Narumbe. I'm 16 years of age and I'm from the beautiful province of Nandronga. In this year's Water Lily pageant, I'll be representing year 1104. Yunaka.
Bulo Fiji, my name is Sara Viliame. I'm 17 years of age. I hail from the beautiful islands of Rutuma and I'm proud to represent 1201.
Malombola Fiji, my name is Vilimayana Atelaite Tuyubanga. I am 17 years of age. I hail from the beautiful province of Lao, and this year I'm honored to represent year 1202 for the Water Lily pageant.
Bulure Fiji, my name is Halomehi Kaloni Viti. I am 17 years of age. I hail from the beautiful province of Mbua, and I'm proudly representing year 1203 at this year's Miss Water Lily pageant.
Bulavinaka Fiji, my name is Emily Tungi. I'm 17 years of age. I hail from the beautiful island of Tuvalu, and this is Miss Water Lily pageant. I'll be proud to represent 1204.
Bulavinaka Fiji, my name is Andili Tietikova. I'm 17 years of age. I'm from the province of Tailevu. I will be representing year 1301 for this year's Water Lily pageant. Vinaka.
Blessia Fiji. My name is Lamani Helen Rova. I am 17 years of age and I hail from the garden island of Tavimi. I am proud to be representing year 1302 in this year's Water Lily pageant.
Bulavinaka Fiji, my name is Naomi Vescula. I'm 17 years old and I hail from the beautiful province of Tailevu, and I'm proud to represent year 1303 in this Miss Water Lily pageant.
To my parents, this is a special event for me as it is the first pageant or such a competition that I enter into. The garland that I wear today, as you can see, it's so green. The leaves are of bamboo leaves and the sandalwood leaves. The bamboo leaves, it identifies the beautiful province of Naitasiri in which I hail from.
Atopo is the daughter of a high chief in the village. Its male equivalent is the mana ear. My headpiece is called a tuinga. It consists of a leula and a palefuono. My necklace is called a ulanifo.
Nisam buluvinaka, malombula and bulare. I am wearing a traditional costume from the province of Mbua. I am wearing a Sulu Chamba specially designed by my mom. A Sulu Chamba is an accepted contemporary wear for women in my village in almost all occasions.
Nwaya Emori and Buluvinaka everyone. On this beautiful afternoon, I am proud to wear a traditional Rotuman attire worn by women when performing in a traditional dance known as a hafa.
The attire that I'm wearing this beautiful afternoon is a three-piece attire. From bottom, it is the skirt, the overlap, and the wambale.
The kuta signifies beauty, elegance, and with my arm piece, it signifies royalty.
The traditional costume that I'm wearing this evening is especially worn by the Tuvaluan only, and this represents the love, the respect that women and men have towards to each other.
Nasulo ndaretiko, nasulo maneani anu vakaturanga kumbao.
Bolavinaa, ladies and gentlemen, the outfit that I am wearing today is a representation of my cultural, traditional, and modern roots.
A famous person once said, "A people without the knowledge of their past, origin, and their culture is like a tree with no roots."
Firstly, I would promote the art of making mahima or sea salt, which my village Lomawai is known for. It is a precious commodity which has health benefits and is good for consumption. Secondly, I would promote the art of pottery making, which the women of Nadronga is known for. It is a useful artifact and is used to create animal figurine, bowls and jewelries, Vinaka.
Back in the village where I was brought up in Komave village in Nandronga, before a rule was applied, young men, they used to misuse by just mixing yangona as a hobby, maybe, and not use it in an auspicious event. So, when a village leader introduced the system that on Saturday, when it's 12 a.m., no one should be involved in the Yangona ceremony. Thus, it prevented young men from misusing the Yangona And back at the village, we had a village canteen, and then it prevented people from coming in and disturbing our family time and our sleep. So it also filled up the church seats on Sunday. Thank you.
Traditional Itauke cooking has always been viewed as healthy for both the body and the soul. Two methods, which are my favorite by personal preference, are steaming and cooking underground using hot stones, known to us all as lovo. These two methods do not require the use of additives or harmful chemicals, and use banana leaves and coconut leaves as a substitute to tin foil, which also makes it better for the environment. If traditional Itauke cooking methods were more widely used, we would see a reduction in health-related problems such as NCDs or non-communicable diseases.
The 11 contestants of the Queen's category also displaying beautiful costumes in Andi Thakombau School's annual Miss Water Lily pageant. The event is held at the school grounds in Sawani and is a day filled with so much color and gaiety. Time for a short break. It's the crowning ceremony next. Join me after the break.